Welcome children. So we completed first lesson, second lesson. Okay, our food lesson was completed and also playing with magnets was completed. The third lesson, which is very interesting, rain. We all love rain, no? When it is raining, we like to play in the rain. We like to throw paper boats in the water. Okay, we like to jump. Mummy says that you will get cold. Don't play in the rain. But whenever it rains. We like to, some or the other reason we will say, we will go out and we will play in the rain and we will come. We all are very much interested with the rain. Is it correct or not? Who will be there? Who won't have interest of rain? All will have. Okay. Now, rain. Actually, where does it come from? What are the sources of rain? What is the use of rain? What are the advantages of rain? Okay. These all points we are going to see in this lesson. Actually, how we are getting rain, from where we are getting rain, what are the uses of rain, what are the advantages of rain, and what are the disadvantages of rain. Here see, in figure 1, Ramya and Soumya were getting ready to go to school. Okay? There, we also will go. Then, what happened here means, their mother advised them to carry an umbrella. Even our mother also will tell, carry an umbrella. When this situation comes, how she can identify that it may rain or it may not rain? How is it possible for her to find out it will rain or it will not rain? The reasons for this one is by seeing the climatic conditions. If it is very cloudy, they may say like that. Okay, if it is cloudy, so they will say that it may rain. If the climate is very cool, cool breezes are touching us, then also we may feel that it may rain. It is very sultry. At that moment, the climate was changed and it was cloudy. Means, if it is cloudy, will it rain? Means, no. I cannot say all the clouds will form the rain. Only few sort of clouds will form the rain. Then which type of clouds will form the rain? So let us see while we are going through the lesson. So here what is happening? So her mother advised them to carry the umbrella. So they got a doubt. Why, mummy, it is not raining, no? Why you are asking us to carry an umbrella? It seems to rain. It may. Not exactly 100%. It may rain, she is telling. So Ramya asked her mother why the umbrella was needed as it was not raining. After looking at the sky, mother told that it was likely to rain as it was cloudy, okay, and windy weather. They started to school wondering about how their mother was able to predict when it could rain. How she was able to find out. So they are having number of questions. What are those? Why do we get rains? Where do the rains come from? How did mother know that it was likely to rain? Do all the clouds form in the sky? See, innovative questions, these are only. If a person asks something, we are having doubts, means number of questions are rising in our brain, means they are only called as innovative questions. In playing with magnets, I gave for you. So, each and every lesson, these questions, innovative questions will be there. And also in the exam also, you will get that innovative questions. So, number of questions, why do we get rains? Where do the rains come from? How did mother know that when? Do all the clouds form rain? So, these all questions are in her brain. Now, rain is a natural phenomenon. We are having cyclic order. Seasonals will change automatically. Up what we will say? About 3. What is that? Rainy after rainy. Winter. Winter after summer. Summer after again? Rainy. Rainy after. This is a natural phenomenon. This is a God's gift. We didn't create anything. We are not inventing anything in this. But we are ready to spoil the nature. Global warming. Okay, cutting the trees. Increasing the cars, bikes, everything. Pollution. Increasing plastic. These all things we are doing. We are the people who are spoiling the nature. If ponds are there, we are removing the ponds and constructing the buildings. Okay, if rivers are there, we are keeping all the dirt, like plastic, flowers, whatever nonsense you like, that all will be in the rivers. Actually, we are having only fresh water 1%. that 1% water also will be spoiled. Who will spoil? We the people. Did you understand? The God gave us a nice sunlight, nice air, nice water, which we have to enjoy that and we have to survive. But the people mindset is going in a wrong way, in such a way that they themselves are spoiling the nature by themselves. Did you understand? These are the things done by the people. Then, like air, water and sunlight. These are the God gifts, as I said for you. We generally get more rains in which season? Rainy season. What is the time of rainy season? June to September. What is the time of rainy season? June to September. Did you see in June rains? July rains? Actually, rainy season means that indicate. In summer season, we are feeling no. The summer season starts from March to May, we are telling. The summer will be from March to May means we can see that full months it is sultry, it is hot, it is sweaty. These things are going on. But in rainy season also the same thing should be happening. No? Means June to September rainy season means we should have rains. Are we having in a cyclic order? No, it is not. Okay, then what is the thing? Our general observation is that if the sky is cloudy, then there is a possibility of rain. We will predict like that. If the temperature is more high, today it will be very sultry. Okay, if the temperature is very low, we will tell, today we should wear blankets and we should be ready with our sweaters and caps, otherwise we will be suffering with cold. If the climate is cloudy, we feel that it will rain. These are the things we are thinking of that. But clouds do not lead to rain every time. Sometimes we witness suddenly rains. Suddenly, without recently it happened, no? Non-stop rains. We got doubt even Hyderabad also will be in floods. We saw that Musi River and near the time when the water level went so high. Is it correct or not? So, if it goes on another 2-3 days means even our Hyderabad also will be with the floods. So, suddenly it may happen like that also. But clouds do not lead to rain every time. Sometimes we witness suddenly rains. Why do clouds cause rain? What is the reason? When clouds are formed only, why we are getting rains? What is the relation between rain and cloud? Why don't all clouds cause rain? To understand about clouds and rain, we need to first know about something about water. First, if you want to know about what is rain, what are clouds, how clouds are formed. If you want to know about all these things, first you have to know about what is water. How is water? Water is of three types. Water is of three types. What are those? Solid, liquid and gaseous. Water is of how many types? Solids, liquid, gaseous. Solid means ice. Liquid means water. Gaseous means water vapor. Gaseous means water vapor. Okay? Here you can see that ice when heated, it converts into water. Water when heated, it converts into water vapor. Take ice cubes and keep under the sunlight. After some time you can see what is that? It converts into water. Take water and put it on a stove. It changes into water vapor. Or leave it in the near the sunlight only. If high temperatures are there, the water will be evaporated and only vessel will be left over. What happened to water? Where water went? Water converted into water vapor. So ice when heated to water when heated to water vapor. Now again, water vapor when cools, it converts into water. Okay, water when cools, it converts into ice. What is this? Water vapor. See, put a vessel of water on the stove and start boiling that water. Okay, after the water boil, you put off the stove and put a lid on that one. After half an hour, you just remove the lid. You can see that the water droplets will be falling. Dan is the best example I'll tell for you. Mummy morning she prepares lunch box and give for you to school. Very very hot rice, dal, everything she'll keep in the box and give. When you open in the afternoon, you can see that water droplets will be coming from that lid. How it is happening? Actually, the hot rice or dal, if you open that, the water vapor will get evaporated. But without the water vapor getting evaporated, what we are doing here? We kept a lid on that one. Did you understand? We kept a lid on that one. Because of that, when I open the lid, the water vapor, it cools, no? After 1 hour, 2 hours, so it is converted into water again. Take this water and put it in the refrigerator. Okay, in deep fridge. This water will be converted into ice. Ice when heated changes to water. Water when heated changes to water vapor. Water vapor when cools changes to water, and water when cools changes to ice. This is called an interchangeable reaction. This is called an interchangeable reaction. This is a 2 marks answer, which is very, very, very important. Ice when heated converts to water. Water when heated converts to water vapor. Water vapor when cools it converts to water. Water when cools it converts to ice. This is called an interchangeable reaction. So, water is in how many forms? 3 forms. Solid form, liquid form and gaseous form. In solid form it is ice. In liquid form it is water. And in gaseous form it is water vapor. Got this interchangeable reaction? Now see here. Solid form. We call solid form of water as ice. Snow occurs naturally. Can we convert water into ice? Is it possible? Water into ice? Yes, if you keep in refrigerator, the water will be converted into ice. Then liquid form. What happens if ice is kept in the open air? If we heat ice, it will change into water. Water in liquid form is present in oceans, seas, rivers, etc. We can see water in, means all the water bodies. What are all the water bodies? Seas, oceans, lakes, etc. These all come under water bodies. Next, gaseous form. What happens when water is heated? The gaseous form of water is water vapor, which is present in air, like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, helium, lithium, neon, like this. These all gases come under, means water vapor is converted into such type of gases. We know that when ice is heated, it converts into water. Just now I told, keep it in the sunlight. In your textbook figure, what he is telling, he took a bowl, he kept ice cubes in that and he kept on the stove. So, what is happening? The ice cubes started heating. Then what will happen to the ice cubes? They will melt and they will be converted into water. So, here, as I said for you, an interchangeable reaction was given here. Ice when heated to water, water to vapor. This is called as an interchangeable reaction. Okay. Evaporation and formation of clouds. What will evaporate and which one will form clouds? What will evaporate? Water will get evaporated. The water which gets evaporated, where it will go? We have to know about that. The water which gets evaporated, is it going somewhere? Is it having wings? Or where it is going? We have to know about that. So, what happens to the water in wet clothes? We will wash daily clothes and keep under the sunlight. Why we are keeping under the sunlight? In 2 cases, on a windy day, on a sunny day. In the 2 cases you take, in which day the clothes will dry up? On a windy day or on a sunny day? On both the cases, the clothes will dry up. On a sunny day also the clothes will dry up. On a windy day also the clothes will dry up. But on a sunny day, the clothes will dry up very fast. Okay? On a windy day, only because of air, it will dry up, but it takes time. On which it will be fresh means, on a sunny day, the clothes will be fresh and new. In the 2 cases, it will dry up. So, when we want to dry clothes quickly, we wave them above or keep them under a fan. Is it correct or not? Does the water in wet clothes dry up only due to sunlight or due to other reasons? as I said for you. On a sunny day also the clothes will dry up. On a windy day also the clothes will dry up. Try to understand. On a sunny day and on a windy day also. But in the two cases if you are seeing, on a sunny day they will dry up very faster than on a windy day. Okay, then you must have seen that water on wet roads, rooftops and some other places dries up after some time though there is no sunlight. If sunlight is not there also, if wet water, now here a little water was there in my room, the sunlight was not there, then also will they stay like that or will they dry up? They will dry up. What is the reason for this? The air which is coming outside will make the water which is down to dry up. Got the point here? So if you heat water kept in a bowl by using a stove, I took a beaker, I put water in that one and I started boiling. Okay, got the point here? I started boiling the water. First what will happen? The water will get heats up. Next what will happen? It will start, the bubbles will come out from the water. After that what will happen? The water will get evaporated. Got the point here? The water which got evaporated, okay, where it will go? This is the question we are having. It gets converted into the water which evaporates will be converted into water vapor and it will mix with the atmospheric air. Where it is going? It is mixing with the atmospheric air. This is what happens to the water in wet clothes also. In wet clothes also, because of the sunlight, the water gets evaporated and mixes with the atmospheric air. Now, what is evaporation? The process of water changing into water vapor is called evaporation. The process of water changing into water vapor is called as evaporation. Did you get the definition? Which is very important. The process of water changing into water vapor is called as evaporation. If water is gently heated, it becomes warm. I told for you, take a bowl of water and put it on a stove. First what will happen? It will warm up. Next what happens? It gets heated up. Next what happens? It boils. Next what happens? It will be converted into water vapor. Then if we heat it further, it evaporates and completely into water vapor. So we know that the amount of heat absorbed by water affects its evaporation. If water is heated more, it will evaporate faster. The remaining lesson I'll continue tomorrow. So here comes, evaporation is a natural process which takes place on the earth. Water evaporates continuously from the water bodies. What are water bodies here? Seas, rivers, oceans, then streams, wherever you find, these all comes under water bodies. From the sunlight, the water will get evaporated and mixes with the atmospheric air. These things will mixes with the atmospheric air, like seas, oceans, rivers, ponds, etc., and change into water vapor due to the heat supplied by sunlight. Where does this water vapor go after evaporation? What happened? The water vapor formed due to evaporation becomes a part of air and mixes with water, cannot usually be seen. The water vapor which enters into the air, that one which mixes with the air, they will be converted into clouds. Now, did you understand how the clouds are formed? The clouds are formed when the water gets evaporated. The water which gets evaporated will mix with the atmospheric air and the water which evaporated is converted into clouds. Did you got the point? Then where this water are converting means, in our house a bowl of water if you are taking or a little water if you are taking, is it that converting into cloud? This is a little amount. Which water will be converted into clouds, sir? The water which we are getting from seas, oceans, lakes, etc. This water will get evaporated and that will be converted into clouds. This is of evaporation. The remaining I'll continue tomorrow. Thank you.